The next stereoisomer is called enantiomer or optical isomer. Before our discussion, let me introduce the term called clarity. Here shows a pair of shoes. The left one is same as the right one, no matter in size, pattern or color. However, they cannot interchange with each other. That means we cannot wear this one on our left foot because these two shoes are mirror image to each other, or simply to say, the left one cannot become the right one through rotation. If we place a mirror in the middle, the image of shoes on left will be the same as the real shoe on the right. With these properties, we call the shoes chiral object. So, the chiral objects are those objects that cannot superpose on its mirror image. Similarly, our hands or our feet are also chiral objects. If we place them in front of mirror, the image will be exactly the same as the other one. However, not every object are chiral. For example, this cup is not chiral because it looks exactly the same as its mirror image. Or we can say the left hand one can become the right one through rotation. Such object is called a chiral. The achiral object are those objects that can superpose on its mirror image. Back to our discussion. How can we know if a molecule is chiral or achiral? Take this molecule as example. After rotation, if we can see there exists a mirror plane or plane of symmetry on the central carbon atom, that means the molecule is achiral. But how about this molecule? As we cannot find any plane of symmetry in every orientation, this molecule is chiral. There is a simple method to determine whether the molecule is chiral or not. If the central carbon atom connected to four different groups, the molecule is chiral. If not, then it is achiral. Consider the following example. Here we have four different groups, so this molecule is chiral because plane of symmetry doesn't exist. And this one, we have two identical groups, so the molecule is achiral because plane of symmetry exists. This method is simple and easy to understand. However, such explanation is not accepted in the DSE syllabus, so don't write this in your exam paper. Only the idea of plane of symmetry is accepted. With this idea, we can sure all carbon atoms with double bonds are achiral because the plane of symmetry always exists as they all have trigonal planar structure. For those molecules are mirror image to each other, they are called enantiomer or optical isomer. For example, these two molecules are enantiomer. What about their physical properties? Enantiomer shows same physical properties except optical activity. So what is optical activity? Scientists discovered that chiral molecule can rotate the plane polarized light to certain degree. Here is an illustration. From the observations through chiral molecule, the image is rotated from the original one, while its enantiomer can rotate the plane polarized light to the same angle but in opposite direction. Here is an example. If this molecule can rotate the plane polarized light for 40 degrees in clockwise direction, then its enantiomer, which is its mirror image, can rotate the plane polarized light for 40 degrees in anti-clockwise direction. And this difference can be measured by using parameter. Don't worry if you have no idea what plane polarized light is, as it is not included in the DSE chemistry syllabus. But if you want to go further, there will be another video for that. What if sample contain equal amount of both enantiomers? Then the rotation will be cancelled out, or we can say the net rotation equals to zero. In this case, the sample is called racemic mixture. The next one is chemical properties. Both enantiomers show same chemical properties only when they react with a chiral reactant. However, When they react with another chiral reactant, different chemical properties will be shown. Here is another illustration. Our feet is chiral, which represent a pair of enantiomer. This sock is an achiral object, so you can wear it on either left or right foot. In terms of chemical reaction, both foot give the same product or shows same chemical properties. Now, let's change the sock to a shoe. This time, the shoe shows chiral properties and only one foot can fit, but not the other one. In terms of chemical reaction, as only one of the enantiomer is allowed to react, the two enantiomer shows different chemical properties. By using this principle, scientists can separate two enantiomers. For example, in drug preparation, maybe one of them is effective in hearing, but the other one is harmful to us. Here is an example. This chiral drug can be used to treat TB, but its enantiomer will lead to blindness. And that's the end of this video.